Hello everyone. In last session, we discussed about the topic the sky. Now I am going to show you a picture. Identify the picture. Which model is it? Observe carefully. See students, Earth is at the center. Moon, Sun and planets are orbiting around the Earth. Means identify the model, which model it is. Earth is at the center means the model is belongs to geocentric model, because we already learned that geocentric model means Earth is at the center, the Sun, the Moon and planets were orbiting the Earth. This was known as geocentric model. Then tell me students, who expounded the geocentric model? Yes. Now I show you a clip. Identify the picture. He expounded the geocentric model. Who is he? Yes, students. He is a Claudius Ptolemy. Claudius Ptolemy expounded the geocentric model. After few years or some years, observe the picture. Who is he? He is a Aryabhatta. Aryabhatta proposed that the Earth and the other planets revolve around the Sun. Observe the picture carefully. In geocentric model, we saw Earth is at the center. But in this model, what we saw? We saw Sun is at the center. But the planets are orbiting the Sun. Means this model, Aryabhatta says that, Aryabhatta proposed that the Earth and the other planets revolve around the Sun. This is known as heliocentric model. Tell me the name of model. The name of model is heliocentric model. Okay, Nicolaus Copernicus, John Kepler also supported this model. Later, see the picture. In this picture, we saw the scientist. What is the name of scientist who invented telescope? Telescope invented by Galileo. He is a Galileo. The instrument we called as telescope. Okay, later Galileo Galilei, an Italian mathematician and physicist, he invented the telescope and using it further supported the heliocentric model of Copernicus. Okay, then tell me students, who invented telescope? Galileo Galilei invented the telescope. Okay, see students, we already learnt about solar system. What we learnt? We learnt about solar system. Okay, in solar system, how many planets are there? We know that in solar system, there are 8 planets. How many planets? There are 8 planets. Okay, tell me the names of planets one by one. First one, planet name is Mercury. Second one, Venus. Third one, Earth. Fourth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. But we learned in solar system there are 8 planets. Here the planet, another one planet is there, that is Pluto. Then tell me students, how many planets are there in solar system? Recently, it has been considered as dwarf planet. Pluto is considered as dwarf planet and is no more a planet of the solar system. Before 2005, we consider in solar system there are 9 planets. After that, the last planet Pluto we consider as it is a dwarf planet. Okay, why we consider it is a dwarf planet? Till 2005, Pluto was considered as the ninth planet. As it did not have all the characteristics of the planet, it was considered as a dwarf planet. Okay. See students, in solar system, we saw 8 planets now. Okay. The 8 planets of solar system in the order of their distance from the sun. Okay. First one is Mercury, second Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Why these planets are arranged in order? In solar system, we saw 8 planets in the order of their distance from the sun. First one is Mercury. The distance between sun and Mercury is less. Second one is Venus. Venus and Earth distance is less compared to the distance between Earth and Sun. On the basis of distance between planets and Sun, we consider there are 8 planets. Before 2005, we consider as in solar system, there are 9 planets. After 2005, we consider that in solar system, there are 8 planets. All the planets are revolving around the sun. Okay. All the planets are revolving or orbiting around the sun. This model, we say that solar system. Okay. Next, see students, here first one planet is Mercury. Second one is Venus. Third one planet is Earth. Okay. On which planet we are living? We are living on Earth. Means we says that Earth is the third planet from the sun. Okay. Earth is the third planet from the sun. Next one is, today we are going to learn about detail about the Earth. It is our home and it is a unique planet in the solar system. Which is the unique planet in the solar system? Earth is the unique planet in the solar system. It occupies the third place from the sun. It is the only planet of the solar system where there is a life, because it has ideal condition of life such as temperature, water and suitable atmosphere with life supporting gases. So we say that Earth is only a single planet where we can lead our life. See the picture students, the picture of Earth. Here is a picture viewing the Earth from the moon. Okay. Then tell me students, observe carefully the picture of Earth. What is the shape of Earth? Yes. Is it a circle? No. It's a round? No. Then what is the shape of Earth? Yes. Try to say the answer. It is confirmed by the scientists that the Earth is slightly flattened. Okay. See the picture carefully. The Earth is slightly flattened. Observe the point carefully. Earth is slightly flattened at the poles and bulging at the equator. Okay, bulging at the equator means, see, observe this part students. Here is a bulging at the equator. This part we says that the Earth is bulging at the equator. The poles are flattened. Okay. This we called as poles. At the center part we says that it is a equator. Okay. It is a equator. At the equator part the Earth is bulging. The sun shape is called, yes, see, at the poles, Earth is flattened. At the equator part,
Earth is bulging. This shape we called as, yes, any guess? What is the shape of Earth? This shape of Earth we called as geoid. What is the shape of Earth? Geoid is the shape of Earth. Then tell me, students, what is the shape of Earth? Geoid is the shape of Earth. What is the meaning of geoid? The meaning of geoid is nothing but the Earth shape. Earth shape we call as geoid. What is the shape of Earth? The Earth shape is geoid. The meaning of geoid is nothing but the Earth shape. It is denoted the Earth is not completely round. Okay. It is denoted that Earth is not completely round or circular in shape. Next, we are going to learn about the size of the Earth. Okay, observe, students. The Earth is the fifth largest planet in the solar system. Okay, remember, Earth is the fifth largest planet. Okay. Which is the fifth largest planet? Earth is the fifth largest planet in solar system. We learned the equatorial part. Can you identify which part we called as equatorial part? Yes, tell me, students, which is the equatorial part? The bulging part of Earth we called as equatorial part of Earth. Then the diameter of, what is the diameter of equatorial part of Earth? The equatorial diameter is 12,757 is the diameter. Okay, the its equatorial diameter is 12,757 kilometer. Kilometer is the unit. Okay, and now you tell, students, what is the equatorial diameter of Earth? The equatorial diameter of Earth is 12,757 kilometer. And see, students, we know that at the upper and lower part we consider as pole. Then tell me the polar diameter. The polar diameter of Earth. Yes. Tell me, the polar diameter is larger or the equatorial diameter is larger? Before that, we need to identify what is the polar diameter. Okay. The polar diameter of Earth is 12,714 kilometer. Tell me once again, 12,714 kilometer is the polar diameter of Earth. What is the polar diameter of Earth? The polar diameter of Earth is 12,714 kilometer. Now, on the Earth, we substitute polar diameter and equatorial diameter. See the picture, students. Here, identify the polar region. Yes, identify. Here, the upper pole and lower pole, we say that polar region. What is the polar region of Earth? 12,000. Tell me, 12,000. 12,714 is the polar region of Earth. We already learned the polar region is 12,714 kilometer. But what is the equatorial part of Earth? Equatorial diameter of Earth is 12,714 57 kilometer. Then tell me, student, either equatorial part is larger or polar region or polar diameter is greater. When we comparing both the numbers, here the equatorial part of the earth was greater, because we know that in 12,757, if we subtract 12,714, we get 43 kilometer. From this we say that equatorial part of earth is greater compared to the polar diameter of the earth. This shows that, what it shows? Yes, tell me, students, what it shows? It shows that polar diameter is less than the equatorial diameter by 43 kilometer. It denotes that the earth is spherical in shape. The total surface area of the earth is, yes, remember the numbers what I am told to you. The total surface area of the earth is 510 million square kilometer. The total surface of earth is 510 million square kilometer is the total surface area of earth. Must remember, the surface area of earth is 510 million square kilometer is the total surface area of the earth. Then tell me, students, how the movements of earth takes place. The earth has two movements. They are the rotation and the revolution. Okay, before that we learned one by one. The earth spins continuously. The earth spins continuously on its axis from west to east. This is called rotation. Observe the picture. The earth rotated continuously on its axis. Here we consider as the central part is axis. The earth continuously on its axis from west to east. This is called rotation. The earth also revolves around the sun along its orbit. This is called revolution. Can you identify the difference between rotation and revolution? Rotation means, see students, now I am going to convey you. Here rotation means the earth rotates from west to east on its own axis. We called as rotation. But here the earth revolving around the sun. So these types of rotation we called as revolution. When the earth rotates itself on its axis from west to east is rotation. If the earth revolve or orbiting around the sun, we called as rotation. The earth continues to rotate on its axis while it is revolving around the sun. See students, in this picture we can say the rotation of earth. From which direction earth start rotating? Earth start rotating from west to east. Am I correct? Yes, earth rotation from west to east side. But how the day and night takes place? Observe the picture carefully. In this picture we saw
sun and earth. When during the earth rotation, one side of the earth faces the sun. See, this face of the earth is faces towards the sun. And it receives sun and receives light from sun. Earth receives sunlight. Correct. Means this we called as day. During the earth rotation, one side of the earth faces the sun and receives light. This part of the earth has considered as day. Which part? Here, sun and earth. Earth faces towards sun, we consider as light or day. Here is a daytime, but observe this part. The other side of the earth does not receive light. Okay, here front part receive light from the sun, but the other part of the earth not received sunlight. So we consider as night. So we consider that night. From this figure, we can easily identify the day and night. Since the earth rotates from west to east, the sun appears to rise in the east and set in the west. Observe, students. Here, earth rotation or revolution takes place. Earth rotation takes place. Here, observe the picture. Can you tell me where the night and day takes place? Here from sun, earth get light. We consider as this part as day. Here we consider as night. This is the difference between day and night. The earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Okay. How much time earth takes to complete one rotation? Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. This is called a day. In next picture, the earth takes 365.25 days or 365 1/4 days to complete one revolution. How much time earth takes? Earth takes 365 1/4 days to complete one revolution. This is called one revolution, means 365 1/4 day. We called as a year. The day and year are a result of the earth's movement. Next is, students, now we learnt about earth. Observe the picture of earth. Can you saw different colors? One color is blue and another one color is green. On earth, blue color indicates the presence of water and green color shows the presence of land or earth. Then tell me, students, how much percent of water covered by earth surface? Yes, observe the picture and tell the answer. About 71% of earth surface is covered by water and the remaining 29% covered by land. Total earth is covered by 71% of water and 29% by land. The earth is surrounded by the atmosphere. Atmosphere has gases. Gases like oxygen. See, O2 is the molecular formula of oxygen, which is very essential for respiration of organism. Then nitrogen, Ni is the molecular formula of nitrogen, and carbon dioxide, CO2 is the molecular formula of carbon dioxide, which is essential for the preparation of food and nutrition of plants. Okay, oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide, which is essential for the preparation of food and nutrition of plants. The water, which is essential for living beings, is available on the earth through the process of, yes, tell me, what is the main source of water? Rain is the main source of water. The water, which is essential for living beings, is available on the earth through the process of water cycle. In water cycle, we saw three processes. One is condensation, evaporation and rain. Okay, from these three processes, we say that water cycle. From the process of water cycle, we can easily get the water. Life on earth has become possible because of the suitable distance between the sun and the earth. Okay, because of that, ideal climate here, with the distance between earth and sun helps to live life on earth. So we says that earth have ideal climate and varieties of soils. Earth have varieties of soils which supply food and water to the plants. Suitable environment, etc. Suitable environment, etc., which are present on the earth. Hence, the earth is a marvelous planet. Earth also we called as marvelous planet. With that, we can identify earth as, or we said that earth is one of the living planet, and we also says that earth is a blue planet. Then earth is a unique planet. Okay, in solar system there are 8 planets. Now the third planet is Earth. Earth is unique planet because we are leading life on Earth. So we say that Earth is a unique planet.
Earth, the living planet. Earth is the third planet from the sun, and it is the only planet to support life because of the abundance of water present in it. Earth cannot produce heat and light of its own and depends on the sun. All living things, from human beings, plants to animals, live on Earth. Atmosphere, which is a layer of air, surrounds the Earth. The surface of the Earth is covered with 3/4 of water and 1/4 by land. So Earth is made up of land and water. What is the shape of the Earth? Earlier, the people thought that the Earth is flat in shape until 500 years ago, when a Portuguese sailor called Ferdinand Magellan proved that the Earth is round in shape like a ball. Later, the people who are trained to travel in space proved this right. These people are called as astronauts. They travel in space through rockets and space ships. When we look at the land and sky from a distance, they appear to meet. This place is called a horizon. Each time we come closer to the horizon, it seems to move further away. But in reality, the land and sky does not meet. The coast. The part of the land near the sea is known as the coast. Even at the coast, it appears as if the water from the sea and the sky are meeting at a distance, which is not possible in reality. The upper atmosphere, which can be seen from the Earth's surface, is the sky. It is everything that lies above the surface of the Earth, including the atmosphere and the outer space. The sky seems to be blue in color, but that is not the actual color of the sky.
Okay, dear students, today in this session we learned detailed about the Earth. Earth is one of the unique planet, blue planet, life leading planet, and it is a marvelous planet. We also learned the movement of Earth has two types. One is rotation and another one is revolution, and how day and night form on Earth, or how day and night takes place on Earth. Okay, dear students, today in this class we learned detailed about Earth, and in next session we are going to learn about the remaining planets one by one. I hope you understood about the unique planet, that is the Earth. Thank you.